far as the Schengen visa goes, for people who are going to go to Europe, I'm sure it's going to be less than 90 days, right? So you usually apply for a Schengen visa. So there's a group of about 25 countries in the Schengen group, which you can visit under a common visa. So when you apply to the consulate of the country where you're going to stay, let's say Germany or France. But the visa you'll get is applicable across the Schengen region. So with one visa, you can travel to France, Italy, Germany, Spain, and lots of other countries where you might want to visit. So that's the visa thing. Until 2 years ago, I think they had a common tourist visa even for internship. But I think this year they have changed that a bit. And they have a separate student visa and internship visa. Is that right? Then if you try to fill the form online, yes. So you would have seen that they have a special internship visa or something. So the procedure is usually easy. For Germany and other European countries, it does not take a lot of time. I guess in Bombay, at least less than a week. I got my visa the next day, but usually it's never less than, never more than a week. However, visa is something which is very, it's very difficult to confirm whether you will get it and when you will get it. So please apply as soon as you can so that you have extra time for any other problems which might happen. For Europe, usually the interview is not an issue. But if you're going to the US, then you will be asked to appear for an interview. You will have trouble getting those dates. And in general, that interview is a very, very, again, as I said, indefinite thing. The general rule is that what they're worried about is A, whether you will definitely come back. So whenever you give answers in the interview, try to assure them that you're going to come back. That's A. B, they are usually worried about the topic of the research. So if it's, mostly does not matter, but if your topic is slightly sensitive, let's say missile guidance, or biotechnology or biochemicals, then try to tell it without using too many dangerous sounding words. For example, all CS people should give very generic things such as optimization or algorithm or something. If they try to ask you more, then give correct information, but try not to sound dangerous. For example, as I said, they usually worry about people working in space technology, space sciences, nuclear, chemical, not chemical in general, but let's say biochemical and so on. And so when you give your answers, make sure that you don't sound suspicious or so on. Usually the questions they ask you are only to ascertain whether you know what you're doing and that you're not lying or faking. So as long as you answer them comfortably, you should not have a problem, especially for internships. Canada, I think, is not a problem at all. You usually are in 1 week. There's a VFS somewhere near Masjid, I think. You can go there, submit your forms and documents, and you usually get the visa within 1 week. And again, in Canada also, I don't think they cause any trouble. So mostly USA is the critical one, so make sure you do the interview well. Also, yeah, when you apply for the visa, usually they expect you to also give a copy of the ticket. They might not always ask you for it, but it's always better because it's sort of a guarantee that you're going to come back. So give them a copy of your ticket, give them a copy of your funding certificate or funding proof. If you're going to fund yourself, give them a copy of the bank statements or something similar. If apart from that, give them a copy of the accommodation proof. If you have gotten something from your professor or something from some accommodation agency there. So Germany has something called the ZAB certificate, which is given by the German Labour Ministry. You need to give that when you apply for the visa. So as I said, I'll not delve on individual countries because it will be a lot of time and get too specific. The general trend is that do your homework well. It is not difficult, but stupid things or overlooking very easy stuff might get you into trouble. So any other visa queries? Japan usually insists on original documents. So you probably need to get some documents from NIMS or the IT or wherever you're going. Yeah. And they usually send you a letter inviting you and giving you the details of your funding and so on and your salary or whatever. Usually the Japanese embassy want that to be an original document, can't be scanned or copied or something. So once you get that from your employer, take that. And they also need an embassy from your institute. So two things. A, who wants you, and then so that's your employment thingy. Can you all hear me?
So A, who wants you? So that's your employer or whatever research institution it is. And B, your home institution, which should allow you to go. So two things, invitation letter, and B, your NOC or something similar from the institute. In general, try to apply for your visa before the end of March, so that in case you have some problems, you'll have some time to correct it. So the transit visa, I'll explain for those who do not know. When you take an airline of any other country, most have hopovers. So you have a stay in another country for a few hours at the airport. Some countries do not need you to have a visa for that duration. Some countries require you to have that. So that's called a transit visa. In general, make sure that if you have a hopover flight, then you look out, check out the website of the transit country and figure out whether you need a visa, a transit visa, and B, how you go about getting one.